Okay, we have Sword of Fire and Ice and Worn Power Stone. There's a tomb. Frantic Search. Frantic Search. No. I don't think I want to go reanimation. I think that's unnecessary for the deck we're making and inconsistent. So I think it's between Power Stone and Sword of Fire and Ice. So I'm gonna go ahead and hide my reanimation stuff now. I had the reanimate. I think I'll leave the Grave Titan invisible. We might still play it. Yeah, I'm gonna go with Sword of Fire and Ice. So I'll try to pick up one or two more creatures for the cheap spots, like Grim Lavamancer. That's a good one. The only thing this is competing with out of this pack is Consecrated Sphinx, I think. Maze of Ith is actually also very good. Very good with Ralzerik too, and other Planeswalkers, obviously. But Lavamancer is really, really good in creature matchups, and it's just a guy for Sword the rest of the time. Sphinx would be better than Grave Titan. Then I wouldn't have to worry about black. I mean, Nicol Bolas, whatever. Yeah, actually, I kind of like that. Maybe one of these will table. I think Maze is a little undervalued. Lavamancer could table. So, we'll see. Let's try to table one of them. Is it Charm isn't half bad? Gives you a range of stuff to do with it. And this pack doesn't really have anything else for us. A Razor Brain Mask Core is playable, but I'm not really into it. We'll hide this, but if we do pick up Sneak Attack, I'll have to remember that I have that. Academy Ruins. No, not good. So I think it's Izzet Charm. It's not a very powerful. What pick is this? Two? Third pick? Okay. Not a very powerful third pick. That's awkward. I guess it's gonna be Misty. I don't really care for Dismember, because we already have a few removal spells. Izzet Charm, Kavu, Xeric, Prophetic Bolt. And I don't want to have too many of those, so I'll go with Misty. Or I could go with Trop. Right now I have nothing to do with Misty. I don't think I have a single thing. And the Brainstorm is already gone, so I guess we'll just go with Trop. Might pick up a green card. Forbid's fine. I'll take Forbid. So now, yeah, our deck's fine. We didn't get anything really to work with Sword of Fire and Ice so far. I think I'll just take the Impulse. Or Badlands would be an option. Would be helpful for casting Nicol Bolas. We'll take Impulse. Wildfire actually isn't a bad card to pick up here. Yeah, I like Wildfire. Daze is also an option there. Phantasmal Image and Memory Lapse. Phantasmal Image cannot be equipped. And other than that, it's fine. But I think Memory Lapse is better. Not as narrow as Phantasmal Image. And I think I'll just take the Predator here, so I don't have to play against it. We do have a Trop, maybe we could board it in. Gargadon, no. No Gargadon here. I think this is where we were supposed to table one of our cards. So now we're just stuck with, I guess, Torch Fiend. It's not half bad. It's a body for sword and it's a shatter. Would have liked the Razor Mane at the very least. Mystic Snake wouldn't be the worst thing. We only have one. Well, we have Trop and we have Diamond. So we have two ways to cast it. I'll go ahead and take it. Counter Magic tends to be pretty good in this format. Chaos Warp, maybe sideboard. Frenzied Goblin. Sure, I can Ranger for my 2-1 drops now. I might actually play that. Or I would actually consider playing that if I had white fixing. But yeah, we're not really anywhere near playing it in this deck. Prodigy. I did say Counter Magic is good, and I definitely think it is. But this guy's a little too narrow. I think we'll sideboard him. It could just be better than Torch Fiend, though. It's definitely not as narrow as Torch Fiend is. We'll see what happens. We'll put those together. Mystic Snake. I really do want to play Mystic Snake. I think it's going to be better than Void Mage. Right now we have Memory Lapse, Forbid, Is It Charm, Glenalundra. So we actually have a reasonable amount of counter magic already. Sundering Titan. So if I'm going to play the sword, I do need more bodies. Maybe just both of these and then forget the snake for so that my mana doesn't get worse. So this is only 17 cards actually. Wow. So let's get these two. We have these mana sources. So we still could have more cards in our deck. We get to cheat on mana pretty handily, but let's see. So that's, yeah, we still definitely have room here. Maybe 2 to 3 cards. So let's go with, I think maybe Chaos Warp. I might prefer Dreadboard or Chaos Warp. The one upside to this is that since we have Wasteland and Strip Mine, we could actually Stone Rain with that little lottery. We'll play the snake. We'll add another creature. So we get these both, actually. So we have 3 bounce lands. This is a crazy deck. All over the place with this one. So if we added 9 lands, we'd have 17 lands, a Mox Diamond, a Soul Ring. But then 3 of our lands are bounce lands, and 2 of them are Strip Mine and Wasteland. So I think we'd be a little bit over on our mana sources, but I think I'm okay with that since we have 2 8 drops, and then we have Wildfire, and then we have Smokestack, and we have Forbid, and we have Visit Charm. Alright, sounds good. Let's see. 5-1-2. Our only black card is Nicol Bolas. We have Mox, Rot Farm. Wait, we didn't pick up anything else? Oh, there's Aqueduct. I thought we had something else to make it easier to cast him. We don't. That's absurd. I don't think I can play Nicol Bolas. I mean, I definitely could, but I'm not that greedy. So I think we'll just abandon black. And then try on Predator. And then add a forest. We still have room for one more land. So I like that because we're not playing four colors, for, and then one of them is for a double color card, and we just added a body to the deck. So, yeah, the deck is definitely all over the place, but I think it's fine. So let's add one more land, and Gitu Encampment is good with Sword. It's a nice little kicker. We could actually cut an island, maybe, for, and then add a forest and a mountain. No, I think I'm just going to add a forest. Okay, well, I think we'll do that.